Hi, this is Dr. Bertalan Meshkul, the medical futurist, and in this episode, I would like to talk about how quantum computers work and show six examples how they will fundamentally change healthcare.
Google officially announced Wednesday it has achieved quantum supremacy. The tech giant says its quantum processor was able to perform a complex mathematical calculation in 3 minutes and 20 seconds. The same calculation would have taken the current most powerful supercomputer nearly 10,000 years.
Google's announcement was a long-awaited milestone in computing because it proved for the very first time that quantum speedup is achievable in a real-world system and that one day these machines will be able to outperform classical computers. Google and NASA have already demonstrated that quantum computers can be at least 100 million times faster than today's computers, and its speed, armed with advanced AI, can change the world more than the discovery of fire, bees, and electricity combined. So obviously, I wanted to know how quantum computers actually work. It was a simple question. How do they work? People were trying to explain it to me, but I found myself smiling and nodding, looking at them blankly. They were speaking nonsense. They say a classical bit is 0 or 1, but a quantum bit is both a 0 and a 1. How? Do they even understand it? I couldn't tell. Maybe they've just learned that line from an article too. How can something be two things at once? I felt like falling into a rabbit's hole. I was wandering around my apartment. The coffee got cold in my hand. Or was it still hot? Maybe it was both. I couldn't sleep anymore. I wanted to crack the answer. Maybe a quantum computer could do it. Maybe, just maybe, a quantum computer can figure out how it works. Turns out, I wasn't far from the truth. While classical computers are based on mechanical structures working through the language of mathematics, quantum computers leverage the strange rules of the quantum world. They rely on two phenomena that happen beyond the atomic level: superposition and quantum entanglement. Superposition is what most people hear about when it comes to quantum computers. Classical computers work with bits, which can be a 0 or a 1. But a quantum bit, or a qubit, can be both a 1 and a 0 at the same time. And observing a qubit makes it collapse into a fixed position. No one knows why that's happening, but as I said, maybe one day a quantum computer can figure out the answer to the mystery of itself. Now, instead of a bit having a defined value as a 0 or a 1, a qubit has a probability of being either.
Flip a coin enough times, and the probability of heads and tails will become clear. In the same way, repeatedly measuring a qubit will uncover the probability that it's in a particular position.
Why is this important? Because the universe works that way too.
Nature is also quantum. Our brains and the drugs we're searching for work in probabilities, so they can only be accurately simulated on quantum computers.
Quantum computers work in synergy with the quantum mechanics of the universe, and they leverage its capabilities. Or how the great Richard Feynman put it, nature isn't classical, damn it. And if you want to make a simulation of nature, you'd better make it quantum mechanical. Now, if the goal was to make one qubit work, the job would have been done already. But the trick is to make multiple qubits work, because that's where the processing power comes from.
The classical bit stores information as a 0 or 1, and a quantum bit can be both 0 and 1 at the same time. If you have two quantum bits, then there are four possible states that you can put in superposition. With three qubits, it's 8, four qubits, it's 16, but grows exponentially.
With more qubits, the processing power grows exponentially. That's the key. because only with a 300 qubit quantum computer, we could perform more calculations at once than there are atoms in the observable universe. And it's all due to another quantum phenomenon called quantum entanglement. Two separate particles can be at the opposite ends of our galaxy and still be entangled, meaning that changing one of them would immediately change the other without any physical connection. Einstein called this phenomenon outright spooky, and it truly is. But it's how quantum computers will be able to work. The trick is to entangle qubits to make them work together, and with that, we can exponentially grow computing power with every added qubit. But the fact is, I could try to tackle the question of how it works all day, and I still couldn't even crack the surface. Right now, we laypeople don't even have the language to fully describe how a quantum computer works. Unless you have a PhD in quantum mechanics and can wrap your head around these quantum phenomena, chances are you won't fully understand it either, just like me. But it's easy to understand that superior speed and processing capabilities of a quantum computer have the possibility to change literally every aspect of our lives. But how close are we to make it a reality?
We at Turbine discover oncology drugs using a simulation platform that helps us lower the astonishing 96% failure rate in clinical trials. I believe that the major scientific leap enabled by quantum computing in our field would be the accurate simulation of protein folding. How these little nanomachines behave is crucially important to understanding how our cells work. And I believe a lot of what we still do not know in biology would be essentially unlocked by having an ability using the power of quantum computers to simulate these tiny systems, these nanomachines living in our cells.
As you can tell, we are not there yet. Far from it. What Google achieved was a major milestone. And maybe in the future, we will look back at this moment as we look at the Wright brothers' first flight. But right now, even Google's CEO says that the first quantum application could be a decade away. And quantum computing in healthcare could be even further if we consider how healthcare systems are notoriously slow adapters of innovative technologies. And even if they will be ready for disruption, quantum computers won't exactly drive the cost down, which is a major problem for most healthcare systems around the world. But Google's demonstration showed us that quantum computing is in fact possible, and eventually it will revolutionize medicine. Let's see how it would do it through a patient journey. First, sequencing DNA at full speed. Even though we are already capable of full genome sequencing and its costs are down to an affordable level, but in the future, genome sequencing will be like a blood or urine test, and quantum computers will be able to analyze the vast amounts of data. Quantum computing can ensure faster sequencing, more comprehensive analysis, comparing your results to those of millions of other patients with similar lifestyle and health parameters. And it will be able to make reliable predictions about what might go wrong with you later and what you can do now to prevent it. Quantum computers can finally help uncrack the human genome, its impact on health and disease, and take out the guesswork from personalized medicine for ensuring better healthcare for everyone. Number two, making patients truly the point of care. Quantum computing can also make another promise of digital health a reality. We already have massive amounts of health data at our disposal. We have smartphones and wearables, health sensors and portable diagnostic devices keeping us informed about our own health and disease management. But quantum computers will be able to make sense of the astronomical datasets and track patients' health on the go. Connected sensor systems might even render physical hospitals useless and truly make patients the point of care. They would get diagnosis and treatments wherever they are. Number three, arriving at the perfect decision support system. We have long surpassed the era when the accumulated knowledge of medical professionals could reside in one professor's head. It's just too much when there are 31 million medical studies with 1-2 million more coming out every year. IBM has tried to tackle that problem when they created their supercomputer and its algorithm, IBM Watson, to sift through millions of studies in a second. But quantum computing could take that to a whole new level and even add some extra skills. These computers could not just use our entire lexical and empirical knowledge in real time, but they could provide the ultimate decision support for doctors. They could skim through all the studies, clinical trials, and textbooks at once. They could find correlations and causations that the human eye would never find, and they could find diagnosis or treatment options that humans could have never figured out by themselves. Number four, drug design. This is where the quantum computer's capabilities are best used for. Drug design would not just leverage the speed and processing power of a quantum computer, but the very nature of quantum computing. Because the way how electrons of the molecules of drugs interact with the human body works by the same principles as quantum mechanics. Simulating quantum phenomena on quantum computers can lead to much faster and much more precise results. Doing all that on a classical computer seems primitive compared to that. Number five, clinical trials. Quantum computing could lead to an era of in silico clinical trials as well. In silico trials mean that no humans, animals, and not even a single cell is required for testing a particular therapy or drug. It's a human way and theoretically could be a fast and more effective path than in vivo trials. Today, completely simulated clinical trials are not feasible with current technology and understanding of biology yet. But with quantum computing, virtual humans can undergo trials and have new drugs reaching markets within weeks from their discovery. Number six, creating the safest medical data systems ever. One of the biggest concerns about quantum computers is safety. Even the dumbest quantum computer could easily crack the safest encryption on a classical computer. Qubits could simply overpower any security. So, our medical records could easily be exposed too, right? Not exactly. What many people forget that while quantum computers could easily crack traditional encryption, they will be also used to leverage quantum uncertainty to create encryption. And quantum security is literally unbreakable. Hackers would have to break the laws of quantum physics to gain access to our health record. The biggest challenge that lies ahead is not whether we in healthcare will be able to understand how quantum computers work, because, no offense, 99% of us never will, but whether we will stop caring about our health when we will be taken care of by the quantum computer. What if we have to prepare for a world where our well-being is neither healthy or diseased, but it has a probability of being either or both? If you like this video and would like to learn more about quantum computing and qubits, subscribe, or don't subscribe, or do both.